What? I don't know, maybe I'm autistic. I would have rerolled the starter to try and get something better. I'm very good. Very good done. So up top we got Panda against Sven. Bottom Panda against...
I think Zaga's doing it the wrong way. Tusk. He should have upgraded to... Okay, what the fuck is he doing?
Yes. It's gonna work good against the Panda. Yeah, this... I think Saga has the better lineup here. Or the better... like his role fits better.
Because he has Sven?
Yeah, Sven is really good, and the Ember matches up really good against the Panda, and it's really good for late or mid to late game as well, because of, yeah, he's got the Sven in front.
Pepe didn't upgrade the Panda yet. 2 seconds left. One. He didn't upgrade the Panda in time.
What?
Oh.
Maybe he just want to make it an exciting game. He wanted to go to game 3 just to have some fun. Who knows? We don't know him.
Oh, Bercut is evil combination. Okay, not against the Panda, but could have maybe worked out better.
That Robo Cup clock, pretty good unit. I don't get why he didn't... Sanop didn't upgrade the Panda either. I'm triggered. They don't believe in him.
Yeah, but Sanop didn't start with the Panda, he started with a Void.
What? Super triggered. Starting with the Void over a Panda, that triggers me. Let's see, can the Panda crit? Pretty sure if he upgraded in time up top though, he wouldn't have fed first blood like that.
He wouldn't have, but he did.
Unlucky. Just where does he go from here? Is there gonna be a tanky Sven in front of the Ember being annoying? So, what do you do about that?
Go for Ember
yourself. Another Panda? Huh?
Could go for an Ember himself. Try to go for Ogre or just reroll.
It's gonna be starter stack, but that's not fun to be against. And clock's in front, that's gonna hurt. Man, all those void evades. He believes, like I do. True Panda player. Too bad it's gonna need a lot of RNG to outperform tanky Sven plus Ember.
Oh, just more Pandas.
Yeah. Ember's AoE is gonna do more damage though than the Panda's cleave. Oh, ultimately it should work out.
Okay, why the hell did Saga go for a storm? Do I need to understand?
I get it. I get the reasoning behind it. I would have rather made like a Dazzle or a Gyrocopter though.
Yeah, I think Dazzle or Gyrocopter either of those two. Untriggered spend for the next wave.
It's still not a bad choice with Storm, but I think, yeah, there are better choices.
I think it is a bad choice because the Storm isn't going against Lycans.
Yeah, but it's still magic damage and AoE damage.
Holy fuck, this one large panda is doing at least one AoE crit every fucking wave.
Seems good, man. So I just gotta believe in the pandas. Panda Helle Heshner. Did you see that commercial with the panda?
Yeah.
Like threatens people with violence and shit. Priceless.
Kodo bottom.
It's not gonna be fun for a casual panda in the void.
Okay, second small storm for Saga.
Well, they got good armor against pandas, you can say.
True, but I don't think he did attack the storm yet with the panda. No, he will.
That crit still hurt. That's too late, bro.
Or?
One value storm though, Kappa.
Stacked Kodo on bottom, and... ah. The other one. What it wanted to stomp.
The Shadow Fiend should get shit on, right?
I think he's just going to die in the AoE stuff.
Yeah. And it's going to dust as well. I'm pretty sure Saga's gonna trash him pretty fast this one. I don't think there's any way around that. It's completely hard countered. Reapers might be able to do something, but I just don't get the casual Shadow Fiend because he's never gonna survive for long when he's only level 1. You can call that.
I don't think the Meepos can survive. Once this vent triggers and then the always AoE damage from the Storms and the Panda, it might not be the fitting damage type, but it's still always damage.
Okay, yep.
Casual slow for nothing.
I finally created the panda, I thought, so I can stop being triggered. It's kinda gonna need some magic damage though. Like, Sanop just has like heavy armor only for frontline, so... And Bercut even has a puck. Oh, I don't get why he would waste time on building a tusk. What?
Okay.
Tusk and Crystal Maiden when you could build a pack? Okay. Alright. Just look at that Sven fucking go. Sven tank and the hole I made it.
Okay, Pip got a guard in front, perimeter guard.
So casual Meepo into casual Shadow Fiend into casual Meepo into Purgatory?
Yes.
Trigger it. Oh. As everything is right now, it looks like we're gonna go to a game 3. Exciting stuff.
That stuff on bottom. Oh, oh.
Yeah. Could have maybe been done a bit faster.
Maybe in the spawn area. Maybe not when the enemies are already attacking.
Yeah. I just don't see how he could ever come back from top. It shouldn't be possible for him to make a comeback with that unit composition.
He should just reroll already.
No, but I don't think a reroll can save him at this point.
Yeah, but the units he has definitely cannot.
Yeah, that's what I mean. I'll let's take that. When that happens, then you need to coordinate with the teammate to make another haste to counter it.
I don't think it stacks like that.
You sure?
I don't think it does. I think it's just.
I thought it's like you can't stack it like. You can't stack the haste twice, but if you have one that cancels out the other, then the third one should either slow or haste, depending on what it is.
I think it's just it's aura like it's slowing and speeding up at the same time and it results in whatever. I don't think it's exactly the same movement speed as without flex. I think it's slightly slower.
Oh
no, it's both 30% should be same.
Yep.
Okay, a third and a fourth small storm. Holy fuck.
Yeah. At this point you can basically make whatever you want and win. Hard looking choice though.
Bottom getting through big time.
Yeah. Should be over within like 5 minutes or so.
So big, but at least it's 2 Kodos.
I think if you made something else than the extra storms, it could go faster. But when the AoE lines up like this,
yeah, that's evil. And there it is, a recycled Kodo from Bercut.
Time to push through. Or is it? Yeah, there's the stump. So, the one thing to take from this series, the guys who get Kodo and recycle it wins. What? And Sven is a good unit.
Ah, but Sanop is pushing on the bottom.
Yeah. But okay, 700 troops behind or in front. But
I think Bercut is feeling it right now that he recycled a Kodo but not on his lane.
Yeah. Yeah, he's gonna. Saga is gonna trash top pretty hard though, I think. Maybe not hard enough, who knows?
I don't think white paper isn't rerolling. I mean, the units he can build definitely cannot win. It's clear by now.
It's a hard game. Hard to do something when you're completely hard countered.
Went through with four anti-level beasts right now.
That's something. Bot lane is reset.
Lucky panda AoE.
Skilled panda crit?
Yeah, it saves the day.
Seems like it's a skilled panda user like me.
So much skill involved in the RNG.
Yeah. You have to build and then you have to believe. If you don't believe it, it's not gonna happen. It separates the men from the boys. I think it's gonna be another triple ancient. If it continues like this, like it doesn't.
Not down, okay. Anthony will be survived, 20 HP.
I think it's possible for Sanop to pull this through somehow. Because if he stacks faster than Saga, then he's gonna get like, say, just 200 gold extra per round. Something like that is. Oh no, let's say 100 gold. That might be more fitting around. That's gonna be another good stack for him.
This fucking clock with bear heal and middle maiden buff. Tanking so fucking many hits from the entrance.
Indeed. Made two tusks. That's not how you.
Not how you win.
Oh, three tusks. Never mind. One, two, three. Four tanks, plus a heal and a support, and then a Kodo. He only has like one DPS unit and that one Sea Dragon, so you can't really make a composition like that when you have a. You actually have a puck, and the opponent has four heavy armor units. So just made a puck.
Casual CM and then reroll. I don't know.
gonna continue to stack bot everywhere now.
Yes.
What's up top? Did he get through?
Yes, but it was most of the stuff. A couple units were didn't make it.
Yeah, okay. Choose when form and value. Saga is 1.3k ahead of both Pepe and Sanop though.
Well, but he's not getting stacks through, he's always getting only one way through.
Two. Three cents through. Still has it.
Upgraded golem for people.
Secret.
Because he's going to outtank three Svens. Four. Sorry, four.
Tanking pretty good.
I wonder how the crit aura works with the pandas.
Well, isn't it just if they don't crit, like if they don't crit like the natural crit of the panda, then they roll another time for that.
Yeah, but when they crit by the aura, do they gain a chance to AoE? Who says that? This game is very strange with its abilities. Okay.
It says grants allies critical strike chance by 15% in 700 radius. It doesn't say anything about AoE, so it shouldn't. I think I would have noticed if that was the case though. And Saga's finally getting through a huge S wave.
Yeah, but still.
Not the whole one.
Yeah, that's still against. The King has 14 upgrades. This isn't going to do much.
Yeah.
Crystal wise, Bercut and Saga are a bit ahead. Saga has 2 upgrades more than Pepe, and Bercut 1 more than Sanop. But Sanop's getting through big time. Again, this wave next, partly this wave at least.
I would have sped up the wave though.
Yep.
Or maybe not theirs.
Okay,
so
at least this is upgraded entity of the beast. Didn't get through. Standing right in the breakthrough point.
I guess this worked out. Fuck. Projectile. Oh, back at the graveyard. Wise choice.
Pepe and Sanop are 1k ahead of Bercut, and they are taking ground from Sanop. Getting pretty close.
Yeah. Be right back.
maybe Bercut might stack.
Yeah, he had.
Like, he's got that Crystal Maiden aura, that's really, really good.
And Sanop went through really bad. He had left standing only a couple units, and it was really. But not stacking. Cool.
Okay.
And he teleported stacked. Away the. Okay. Bercut teleported away the new Kodo to Sanop's lane. He's going to pay hard for that. Okay, the new Kodo isn't even doing anything, it's just running through. This wasn't good. Oh, 1, 2, okay.
Here we go. All in, boys.
Ah, but Sanop.
It's a really good choice time for them to all in, though, because they've got a huge wave and the other. It's gonna take some time before.
It's only one. It's one spawn from Saga, and Sanop is getting through. Right, will be getting through.
Yeah, but they need. No, they. I think that's wrong. They needed to wait for the wave up to go through before they made generals.
You mean with yes, that doesn't
make
a good decision. That's true. Still think this might be working. Nah. It's not a death push. Definitely.
Okay. That was pretty close. Oh.
Not many units left.
Three units.
And Bercut, he committed the Bloodstone as well for that. Oh, got Saga with the Ring of Regen. Trademark item.
And Sanop is never, he's basically never getting the full stack through. He's always getting half. He's always getting his front lane and maybe one or two backliners through, and then.
Oh, he got the buckler level 3.
Who?
Maybe, blah blah blah, Sanop. Maybe that's what helped the push not get through. I'm not sure.
Armor increase 40 for 15 seconds. Holy shit.
I should get
that item more often.
I get it if I can afford it, but you usually just buy it for the all-in pushes, so you get it on the generals. But like, it's still like really, really, really expensive compared to just getting the Bloodstone. He forgot to haste out his wave.
I think Saga will get a full wave through this time at least. Well, yeah, he should be getting full wave through. He's not. Never mind.
At least haste now. Oh man, Sanop could have hasted this wave out too, as well. Never mind. He doesn't need to.
I don't think this game is getting any better for Saga and Bercut, because Sanop is winning way harder than Saga is.
Yeah. So chainmail and Saga going for mass armor with the casual Ring of Regen. I think you need the Ring of Protection though as well on the chainmail, because you just got a few Svens tanking anyway. It's not like you use the armor on your backline. You should just have like some DPS, I think.
I think Saga should just get more units, to be honest. Or like anything. More hours or more range or whatever.
No, they got the same unit count now. But should change soon.
Saga only has like 3 units that don't deal AoE damage.
Some AoE commitment right there. That should be almost. Nope. Still not the full wave triggered.
And why the fuck didn't Pepe ever reroll? I don't get it.
I still haven't. I still haven't.
Still a stalking roll. Why?
It's interesting.
My holy fuck, this wave from Saga. Basically, about every unit has a fucking regen effect. Not that it would be doing anything, but.
It's got a lot of those embers.
But to what end? What are they going to accomplish? I don't see it yet.
This first. So he doesn't have a front line, and then the next wave mops up and he doesn't leak. Like, it makes sense. It's a weird way, but I would agree. I would have rerolled as well.
Ah, the Kodo is running somewhere else. Fuck the shit, I'm out.
Top which one?
And okay, no, it's running in the right direction.
Well, oh, that worked.
Yeah, it's only a bit behind.
I've teleported one to the king as well, like a panda, I think, and then he just started running away. Like, nope, yeah. I'm not doing this.
Fuck the shit, I'm out. Pepe is slowly but steadily he's getting back into his lane.
But it's still like 2k gold behind it or something like that.
It's 1k, not even 1k. Okay, Blaga has 1.5k armaments, but.
Oh, that's what I mean.
Ah, okay. Bercut has the hardest one of evasion level 2. That's nice. He's still getting cucked really hard on his lane, but. He's going for Medusa's now, maybe. So help.
Might do something.
Only
I guess they're only getting a few units through
it's
each
never
round.
Even a one full way through. Okay, why did Pepe build an other 8th tier right in front? Okay, maybe he wants the units to go there, but why an 8th tier? 50 rounds in.
Which what?
Pepe built a new 8 seer, the unit on the bottom, the most forefront unit. And
oh, what? I don't know. Maybe just to draw attention.
Yeah, maybe. But still, then he could go for a middle one or even a small one. Or whatever, anything else. Or just reroll and get real units already.
Yeah. Sanop's gonna get through a good wave again. Against all odds. So quarterstaff and morbid mask. That's not too bad. Like morbid mask is really sweet on the pandas. Attack speed too. Regaining that Medusa damage, some of it at least. I hope the game isn't gonna crash.
I was two players, you need to play very, very long for it to crash.
Okay.
Saga got through most of his stuff.
Yeah.
Saga is really committing for mercenaries now to finally get something good through, I think.
Yeah.
Okay, people is building an other.
Get the mage here, son. Maybe he's doing it just for BMing, you know? Like, yeah, I got this. I don't need to reroll. Don't worry.
But he built every aura unit. He built fucking huge amounts of flame emperors and pandas. What the fuck is he waiting for?
It's Christmas in a month and some days.
Oh, maybe.
Bloodstone. Saga's gonna get to renown host for sure.
Yeah. this is a big one now.
I like that voodoo heal stack though.
Is Saga doing it? Yes.
Yeah. Man, he probably spectated my games and stole my strats.
Okay, there is another go. But I think Saga and Treehead, they shouldn't be having 12. They have 4.
You mean Bercut head?
I'm not sure, but Saga definitely shouldn't have enough crystal because he's spending mercenaries like crazy.
They're not gonna get a wave through though. So I think team Saga Bercut is gonna clinch this one out now.
They should use a king.
Yeah, they should win this.
They should use a king, that's another. And Sanop should use. Okay, he did
use
a buckler.
Yeah, but they should have win this.
No, he used the buckler. So 7 plus 4, 50 armor on the fucking. They aren't going to get through that. It's not going to happen.
Oh, nice.
Saga is going to clean up the rest and then.
Oh, he's so close to getting through up there.
He will get a few units. That's Zanop's gonna got through big again. End of the day, nothing happened.
Holy fuck, this game. No, but a huge wave is coming now, you know? Yeah. I think this should be. Yeah, this is over.
Oh, there's still three.
Yeah. Them heal wards though.
The king isn't dealing damage. Awesome, he cannot kill the units because they heal too fast.
Well, this is gonna be a game 3. This was a pretty cool game.